Good morning, my dear students. So we are solving a problem in portal frame method. A laterally loaded frame. So the step one calculation we have discussed in the last session. So the screen that you are seeing now is the solution after step one calculation. Okay, it is to calculate column shear. So column shear is calculated in the in the case of portal frame using portal method. Okay, so proceeding for step two. So once you get the column shear values, which is calculated from the assumption two, particularly for portal frame. Okay, so portal method has got two assumptions. First assumption is to have hinge in the middle of each member. Nothing but zero bending moment point. The second assumption is the column shear in the interior column is twice that of the exterior column. So these two assumptions are now key points for us to proceed for the entire solution. So after step one, the next connecting quantity is column end moments. Okay, so after knowing column shear value, you are able to get column end moments. Okay, so let us see how it is to be done. So if you take column AH, right, so this 10 kilonewton is going to cause moment at A, and the 10 which is here is going to cause moment at H. Okay, right, so this is how we calculate the column end moments. So because you take a section anywhere that you are going to have the same shear force value anywhere, right? So this is as you have only the lateral loads and there is no other loads present, applied loads present. Okay, so shear value is 10 at the midpoint of the column. This is the place where you have calculated the column shear. So moment at this point is going to be, okay, this 10 into this distance. So all column heights are 4 meters. So this will become 2 meters. This is 2 meters, right? So your calculation will be, now you see moment at A in column AH, your notations are to be very particular where you are calculating moment and in which column. Okay, please take care of the notations where you are calculating moment and in which column. Okay, so it is just by multiplying column shear, whatever you have calculated in step one, half of the story height, if the story height even it is even changing. So you must be careful with that values also. Say if the bottom story height is just 2 meters, then the middle is 3 meters, then the upper story is 4 meters, then you must change the calculation according to that story height. Right, so column AH, the top story leftmost column, so shear is 10, the half of the story height is 2 meters, nothing but 4 is the story height by 2, half of it, okay? That will give you 20 kilonewton meter. And the direction of moment is, see, it is mentioned here is clockwise. The reason here, the arrow of shear is towards left. It is going to cause moment in clockwise direction. So this is the direction of moment at this point A. Okay. So clockwise is the direction. Right. And even at location H in column AH. So first letter denotes the point where you are calculating moment. And the next letter denotes the other end of the column. So AH is the column. AH is the column. Same column here. So other end. H is the point where you are calculating moment. So the other end of the column. Even H will have. See, the arrow is towards right. And the moment is going to be clockwise again. So 10 into 2, 20 is the value. Okay. So here also 20, here also 20 means moment at A is 20 kilonewton meter, even moment at H is 20 kilonewton meter, and zero at the midpoint. Okay. Both are clockwise moments. Okay. So that is what is shown here, right? So this step till this point is for column AH, and you can see I have added column DE also. Let us see what it is. Column DE is the rightmost column in top story. As the shear force is same and the column height is same, so moments are also same for DE. That's why I have added that in the same step of calculation. Okay, so you have calculated the leftmost column bending moment and the rightmost column bending moment just by multiplying the shear force into the half of the column height. That's all. 10 into 2, right? Right, going for the middle columns B, G, and C, F. Okay, let us see B, G. This one B, G, column B, G, and C, F. So shear is 20, and the distance here is 2 meters. Half of story height. So 20 into 2, which is what? 40. Same here, 20 into 2 is 40. Okay. So column BG or even column CF, the same shear force and same 2 meters. Half of the story height. So story height same and shear force same. So BG and CF will have same bending moment. Okay, so 40 kilonewton meter is even at B or at G, both are same. And even for CF and column, both at C, point C and point F. Okay, it is same. So you have calculated 4 values in the step one. I mean to say first step of calculation in this column end moments calculation. Then another 4 values are here. So likewise, you are going to have values for each. Now, this is for top story. This is for middle story. This is for bottom story. Right? So you have 6 values. In fact, but six different values, but in each value you have four values again, okay, at A, at H, and at D, and at E. There are four values in each calculation, okay. So total six different values, and each value is of equal to four, so 24 values you have calculated, okay. Right, so let's go to the middle story. Let us see the bending moment, column bending moment. So 15 is the shear force. Story height is 4 meters again. So half of that is 2 meters. So don't be in a hurry to just multiply 15 with 4. Okay. You have to take half of the story height. So 15 into 2. So it is going to be 30. Same here at point I also. So HI column. This point is H, this point is I. So HI column, same 15 into 2, 30. So 30 kilonewton meter clockwise. Even at top or at bottom, it is clockwise. So let us see in our calculations. So HI, so at H, 15 into 2, 30 kilonewton meter clockwise. At I also, 15 into 2, 30 kilonewton meter clockwise. The same for the right end of the frame, okay? So which means EL, column EL. Reason, shear force is same and story height same. Okay, so middle two columns will have different value. So GJ, FK will have different values. So that's this one. So GJ, the shear is 30, half of the story height 2 meters. So 60 kilonewton meter clockwise at G, and at J both are same. Even the next column in the middle, okay, middle story, two columns, two interior columns will have same value, 60. Okay, so if you see that 30 into 2 clockwise here and 30 into 2, 60, right? Even FK also same, 30 into 2 and then 30 into 2, okay? So 60 here. Middle story has got two bending moment values, 30 for exterior columns and 60 for interior columns, whereas 20 for exterior columns in the top story and 40 for interior columns. Next, coming to the bottom story, so column IP, column LM, LM, column IP. So bending moment value 20 into 2, 40, so the value here is 40. Even at bottom P also 40, same here, 40 kilonewton meter clockwise, 40 kilonewton meter clockwise at L and M. So I and P, L and M will have 40 kilonewton meter bending moment. Just see that. So 20 into 2, 40 kilonewton meter clockwise, for ip at I, column ip at P, even the right hand side lm ml, okay. And the bottom story middle two columns, let us see middle two columns also. So 40 into 2 80 is the value. Same at O also 80, 40 into 2. So J O and K N also will have same values as that of J O. Okay, so exterior 40 kilonewton meters, interior 80 kilonewton meters, right? So all these values you must show it in the same diagram where you have drawn the step one answer. So we have completed step two calculation with this. So you have calculated all the column moments, okay? So J O O J interior, K N and N K, okay, right? You have all the values and you should show them with the value and the direction and location in the diagram. That is, you know, just whatever I have drawn while calculating, the same you should show it. As I told you, first have an empty frame, there you draw step one answer, then the same diagram, step two answer you draw there, okay? So your calculation will be like this. So your answer will be posted in the initial diagram that you have kept for posting all the answers, okay? So that you save your time. So need not draw for each step the answer, then finally the one final diagram likewise. So if you have time, you can do it, no problem. So these notations I have put it in the diagram that I will show you. So this is the one, okay? So 20 and then 20 here, okay? So top story, okay? 20, so clockwise 20, clockwise 20, 10 into 2. Then clockwise 40, 40, 20 into 2. So same for middle columns and then same for exterior columns. You see that, see, what care you should take while drawing this diagram is, so column moment you notate just an arrow crossing this column, that's all. Don't extend this line to the beam, because you need to draw beam moment also here. So just have an arrow just like this, that's all, a curved arrow like this, that's all, okay? Moment, showing moment is like this, okay? So a simple curved arrow you just show there, so that when you draw beam moment you have to draw it like this, so to not to have a clumsy notation, okay? So that's how it is. Right, so what you see now is the step two answer. So 20 exterior column, the top story moment, then 40 interior column moments, then 30 and 60, and 40 and 80. So there are six different values, but in fact you have four columns. 4 3 is 12 columns in total frame. So 12 into 2 ends, upper end and lower end, 24 actually, the 24 values in total. The similarity, because of similarity, you have got six different values: 20, 40, 30, 60, and 40, 80. Okay. So this is how simple the step two calculation is. Just by multiplying with the shear force and the half of the story height, that's it. Okay. But where is the difficulty then? It's just the notation, how you draw, is much important, and the nomenclature that you use, like column AH, M AH, MHA, where you are calculating moment, all these plays much important role. Okay, because if you just write 20, you know where it is, which direction it is, which column it is. Okay. So all these you must be careful. Okay. So calculation is just much simple, but to show it in the diagram, you need the direction, you need the value, and you need the location where it is, and that is here. So you see, all three are here. This moment is at A, calculated at A for column AH, and it is the value 20. And the direction is clockwise. All three are present there, you see. So value 20, direction clockwise, the location A in column AH. So likewise, you should be clear whatever you do in this step two. Okay. So this is step one. Along with step two, you can see the answer, right? So this all with this step two calculation, and we will proceed for step three, step four, step five calculations in the next further sessions, right? So practice this problem on a big white sheet so that you will have a very clear idea. So practicing number of times will make you to accommodate with this drawings, particularly in this. Much more important are the drawings that you do in this unit 2. Okay, right, thank you.